Good morning. We apologize for the slight delay due to a technical problem. It is a pleasure to host this national level webinar on NAC related quality enhancement initiatives. As we all know, NAC accreditation is an essential prerequisite for the successful functioning of a higher education institution in India today. We need to have a fairly good understanding of the revised accreditation framework of NAC assessment so that we are able to prepare our self-study report in a proper manner. At the same time, we need to think of diverse ways of improving the quality of education in our institution. It is with some of these objectives that the internal quality assurance cell of our college has organized this national web. A very eminent resource person, Dr. Dharmadhikari NS, to guide us through his talk today. At the outset of this webinar, I request the principal of our college, Dr. Sudarshan Kumar, to welcome everyone.
Good morning. It is my pleasure to welcome the guests for the national webinar organized by the IQAC of Sri Davada College, Mudubidri, on the topic NAC related quality enhancement initiatives on this Independence Day. The inaugurator of this national webinar is Sri Abhijit M, Secretary of Sri Digambara Jaina Vidyavardhaka Sangha, Mudubidri. He is the backbone of the institution, very dynamic and supportive to the educational activities. I heartily welcome you, sir. The resource person of this national webinar is Dr. Dharmadhikari, educationist and academic consultant in the field of higher education. The IQAC of the college requested him to deliver a guidance talk on quality enhancement related to NAC. He kindly consented as a resource person. On behalf of the management, college and all the participants, I warmly welcome you, sir. I am delighted to welcome all the participants, College IQAC Coordinator, Dr. Padmaja Shetty, Technical Assistant of this seminar, Srimati Akshata Marathe, and all the faculties of the college. Thank you.
Our college is managed by Sri Digambara Jain Vidyavardhaka Sangha, Mudubidri, which has a history of more than a century and has reputed educational institutions under its umbrella. We are glad to have Mr. Abhijit M, Secretary of Sri DJV Sangha, with us this morning. I now request Mr. Abhijit M to inaugurate this webinar with his inaugural address.
Good morning to all of you. It's been, great changing times where we need to revisit the foundation of education, basically the quality of education, I feel. So I understand NAC is playing a very important role in framing a quality of education in the higher education segment. It's really a changing time where we are all expecting that education tech, edge tech would replace teachers, but such balance is not at all practically possible. But still, we are in a changing times where we need to look to revisit the foundation of quality in education and how to deliver it to students in this new normal life, I should say. And in this regard, I think NAC's suggestions, NAC's view on this would be very important role to play in the education system of the country. With this, the NAC assessments, everything I think need to be directed towards the new normal, I feel. So with this background, I am really proud that this session is organized by our college, Davada College, and I really am happy to inaugurate this. And I also wish all of you a very pleasant session. And I think Dharmadhikari sir would be very, very experienced person in this regard, and he would be very useful to all of us in this seminar today. Thanks for the opportunity given to me for this inauguration. Thank you.
It is my pleasure to introduce a resource person to you. Dr. Dharmadhikari NS is a Pune-based educationist. He is a retired principal working in educational field for the last 40 years as principal, director and academic consultant. He has been appointed as quality advisor by Times of India Campus Technology Bangalore for quality enhancement in India. He has been appointed as quality auditor by Kendriya Ayush Mantralaya New Delhi. He has received prestigious award for extraordinary contribution in higher education from Bharat Shikshan Mandal Mumbai. He was invited for an international conference at Atlanta, USA. He was invited as a guest of honor with Honorable Governor of Allahabad. He is an ex-member of Senate and Academic Council of Universities in Maharashtra. As an educationist, Dr. Dharmadhikari has delivered talks on ancient Indian mathematics on All India Radio and TV channels. He has been guiding MPhil and PhD students and has published research papers on ancient and modern mathematics. He has published articles on education in newspapers and magazines in English, Marathi and Hindi. He has delivered keynote addresses in various state, national and international conferences. He was invited for International Vedic Mathematics Conference. Presently, a member of NAC and UGC committee, Dr. Dharmadhikari has delivered nearly 1,000 guidance talks on quality enhancement related to NAC in all states of India in the last 11 years through webinars and conferences. With this brief introduction, I would like to say that we are privileged to have Dr. Dharmadhikari NS as our resource person for this national webinar. All of us are eagerly waiting to listen to Dharmadhikari sir. So, I now request Dr. Dharmadhikari sir to begin his talk on NAC-related quality enhancement initiatives. Over to you, sir. Hello, sir. Sir, you may continue, sir.
Okay. Is it okay?
Yes.
So, I was telling you the sentence ICT, industry-based I explained, then outcome-oriented I explained. And now academic performance, when I say, I repeat again, you will find that academic performance will not mean only university result, but you have to explain. Suppose 500 students got the degree from your college during NAC 5 years period, then you have to explain how many students got the job on campus, how many have received off the campus, and how many are self-employed, are having own self-business, or going to PGs, higher studies. So in that manner, 90%, 100% students are involved. You have to give the in report. So remember, that is the academic performance. Then comes, as I have given you, with collaboration. You have to work with collaboration MOU for academic purpose, social purpose, hospital MOU, environmental MOU, whatever it may be. With MOU, you must have a large number in that way and you have to work that. Then neighborhood community connect. You have to have some outreach program, extension program, social program, subject-related awareness program also for the neighboring community. I shall tell in detail after some time. Then I have written by using technological amplification of learning. That means what type of technology you are having, you are knowing. Actually, what technology is there in London, in Chennai, in Bangalore, in America. In that manner, you have to think and you have to give the awareness of latest trends of technology to the students. So in that manner, this sentence is very important. You have to work accordingly. You will find that your NAC future depends upon what you do daily and innovatively. That is very important. Now this new education policy, national education policy is coming in 2022. There are so many things in that. You will find that quality is required there. You will find that in that education policy that is coming, you will have degrees of the type BLE, BLEA, Bachelor of Liberal Education, Bachelor of Liberal Arts. A student can take optional subjects as chemistry, economics and music also. No barrier of faculty. But remember, teaching universities and research universities will be there. There is no affiliation colleges now. So every college will be autonomous, but they must get the grade 2.50 above. And lot of funds also, they are coming from that education policy. So you should be prepared with higher grade to get lot of money from the government. So I am telling you, this educational system that is going to come, it is in fact educationally do or die. Do not ask why. You have to perform with quality. I may tell that POP is required. Actually, POP is required in building. But I say POP in this education policy also, perform or perish. If you perform with quality, it is well and good. Otherwise, you will be out of the picture. I read one book of Noble Harare recently, a thinker. He has written good book, 21 Lessons for 21st Century. And in his book, he has written that clarity and quality, they are the powers of this 21st century. Same is expected by NAC. You have to give clarity, you have to give quality also. This is the period of misinformation and over-information on WhatsApp, on viral, everywhere. So you should be particular in giving correct, justifiable evidences, correct information. Remember that this quality is like a quality card, like ATM card, Paytm card, credit card. This quality card, it must have magnitude of the qualities of the college and direction which I am giving that is to be implemented. So all these things you keep in mind and go accordingly. You will find that you have to adopt a positivity everywhere. Positivity, you will find that it is by choice. Easy to adopt. But negativity is not easy to adopt. You have to give up that negativity. So all the time you have to work with proactive mindset in the colleges in that manner. So I am telling you all these things. Some participants in this webinar, they may be afraid of NAC. I say that do not be afraid of NAC. NAC is a simple procedure in my opinion. Peer team, that letter comes to the principal, peer, then comes fear in mind, what will happen? Then they come to college, they become near, and when they leave the college, they become dear. So it is simple procedure. Peer, fear, near, dear, provided in the bracket, you are showing proper reasons. You are telling relevantly. Then it is all this way. Otherwise, everywhere, fear will be there and grade will be lower down. So remember all these things very well and go for NAC. Hindi, you may be understanding Hindi also. I may tell one Shero Shari share in Hindi. That is influential. So that share is in this manner. Ab hawaein karegi roshni ka faisla. Jis diye mein jaan hai, wahi jalega. Everybody knows that. But I say now, ab NAC grade karega college ka faisla. जिस कॉलेज में क्वालिटी है वही चलेगा, बाकी सब कॉलेजेस बंद हो जाएगी. सो यू हैव टू थिंक इन दैट मैनर. आई गिव इन एवरी टॉक टू वर्ड्स टू रिमेंबर फॉर NAC पर्पस. द फर्स्ट वर्ड इज स्मार्ट. आई से दैट एवरीबॉडी शुड बी स्मार्ट. व्हेन आई से स्मार्ट, दैट मीन्स वेयरिंग गुड क्लॉथ एंड स्पीकिंग वेल. दैट स्मार्टनेस इज नॉट देयर. आई से स्मार्ट मीन्स यस स्टैंड फॉर स्पेसिफिक. हाउ मच स्पेसिफिक यू आर in communicating, in writing something, that is very important. Do not write in the report, various activities are done, different activities are done. You know that you have done 40 activities. You know that you have done 100 activities. So write specifically 40 activities are done. Some various, different, such particular words should not be there, vague words. So that is one thing. So specificness is important. Then in SMART comes M, that M stands for measurable. Everybody is measurable from others' eyes. After getting the appointment in the college, principal and management are also measuring you all. Whether you are for the development of the college, development of the student, in that manner. I may tell you a simple example. Suppose if you want to teach in the class for 45 minutes, you can prepare at home very well. You will teach also very well. But if your preparation is not good, then in your teaching, you just chit-chat something, and then student will measure you, and then student will think that this teacher is not updated, but he is outdated teacher. So that measurable process is going on. Then comes in SMART, it is A. A stands for achievable. How much achievable you are? If you are not PhD, register for PhD. If you are PhD holder, do some research work for removing the diversities of the neighboring community, along with the research paper published in international journals. All these things that comes under achievability. Then comes in SMART, it is R. That R stands for relevant. How much relevant you are? You are teaching with yesterday skills. It is highly impossible to develop the student for their better future. You have to take latest skill and potential. So that relevancy is important. Then comes in SMART, it is T. That T stands for time bound. You have to work time bound. That means in time and to the point. I am giving so many systems in my talk to all principals. I shall tell first system in this manner. You have to work time bound in this manner. Do not depend upon the notices. You just give first information to the department that in coming 8 days, you collect the matter required for NAC purpose, whatever they have done up till now. Then criteria persons will go from department to department, collect the matter accordingly. They will write the question answers there, submit to IQAC. IQAC will have some correction team, modification team, and they will correct that SSR for 15 days. Make a final fair copy. Put on principal's table. Again on the principal's table, it should be kept for 8 days again for modification, correction, because if you send it to DAC office and if it is rejected, again for resubmission, 1 lakh, 2 lakh penalty is asked. Two principals came to me recently. Their reports were rejected. Reasons are coming in my talk. You will come to know. So you will find that they were telling that our report was rejected and for resubmission, they are demanding 1 lakh rupees to pay. So in that manner, the things are going on. You should be very careful. Next time, I may tell you, for that purpose, three senses are very important. First is sense of reasoning, second is sense of proportion, and third is sense of priority. This sense of reasoning means justifiable reasons, proper reasons you have to give. Sense of proportion, when I mean, that means you know the words knowledge and wisdom. So this proportion is required in this way. Actually, knowledge is required for what to write and what to speak. Wisdom is required for what not to write and what not to speak. And skill potential is also required for how much to write and how much to speak. So all these things, they come under sense of proportion in writing and in speaking. And third one is sense of priority. This priority should be given to NAC core values, five principles of NAC. Which are they? Number one, national development. Whatever things are going on national level, state level, you should take awareness program to the community, to the student, and in courses form also. GST has come, demonetization has come, Article 370 removal was there. So at that time, you must take something of that type. So Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao program was there, Mangalyaan Chandrayaan was there. So subject related such activities, you should take. National development. Then second one is global competency. When I say global competency, everybody says, think globally and act locally. But that talking is in one direction and walking is in another direction. When you say think globally, you have to really think in that manner. You have to think that your graduate student should get an appointment in international company. Maybe World Bank, maybe NASA, maybe some IT company at London, America. So you should give them training according to that. You should give online courses also according to that. So think globally, act locally, it should go in that manner. Then third core value is quest of excellence. That quest of excellence should be there in every college, quality initiatives, quality announcement, and quality sustenance part. Then next, it comes using modern technology. I'm telling you in detail after some time. Last one is code of conduct, core values of the college. You have to prepare this document of core values, national values, code of conduct, and you have to give awareness program to student and community, student and faculties also. Prepare the document, put on college website. All documents should be uploaded on college website now only, even though your NAC is after 3 years, 4 years also, because that is necessary. So this sense of reasoning, sense of proportion, and sense of priority, that part is very important. Then one more word I shall give you, that word is pride. Actually, pride should not be there, but professional pride, I am telling you. That P stands for positive working environment. That should be there in the college. Suppose PRT members are on the campus, two faculty members or two students are looking to the mobile, speaking loudly on the ground of the class, on the ground of the college, that picture should not be seen. Even I can say that PRT members are sitting in principal's cabin, principal calls you somebody, you should go there within no time. Because otherwise they will think what is the relation between principal and staff. They are not positive to each other. Then comes in pride, R. That R stands for recognizing everyone's effort. You have to prepare encouragement and welfare schemes for students and faculties and upload on college websites. Here team member will ask to management and principal also while taking lunch on the first day, what are your encouragement and welfare schemes? What are your encouragement and welfare schemes in the college? So that thing is very important. So remember this recognizing everyone's effort is important. Then comes I stands for involvement of everyone. That is very important. Involvement of everyone is tested by PLT members. I had been to a college in Orissa some days back. I asked that faculty member, what contribution have you made in sending this report to NAC office? That particular staff member told me that I have not done anything. Principal and coordinator have done it. Do not do that. For this also, I am giving you the system. Principal should distribute all questions of the criteria to all faculty members in the college. So everybody will have a responsibility of 3 to 4 questions. After my talk, they will think innovatively and do that activity in coming 3-4 months and then write in the report and send it to NAC office. So the involvement of everyone, if somebody asks, then that involvement of everyone, everybody should say. Then in pride it comes D, that D stands for development of skill and potential. First develop yourself and then student. Then pride E stands for effective evaluation, feedback and placement. Effectiveness is very important. When I say evaluation, generally in the report, university evaluation methods are written in detail. Whereas college internal evaluation methods you have to write in detail. For this also it is rejected. Irrelevant answer. Then comes feedback. When I say feedback, every department should take feedback on syllabi from student, teacher, alumni, parent and employer. You submit it to IQAC. IQAC will have analysis team. After analysis, IQAC will give a letter to the principal and principal will send a letter to affiliated university in the following manner. That in the coming revision of syllabi, in botany subject, organic farming chapter is not there. In commerce, GST chapter is not there. You include. In that manner you have to give and that will complete the answer. Feedbacks are taken, analyzed and improving measure is taken by the principal. All documentation you have to show. You will find that main thing you have to write with evidences in this manner. Notice by the principal, list of participants' signature, outcome or feedback of the activity, geotag photos and video clips. Paper news cuttings also, they are okay. So in that manner you have to think for that. So I told effective evaluation, feedback and then comes placement. This placement is very important. On campus, off campus, own business, you have to write in detail. I know that Tata Ambani, Birla, these people, they will not come to villages for giving appointments. NAC also knows that. But what is expected by NAC? That efforts for placement and coaching for competency exam done extensively every year. I should explain how. So remember this type of pride concept you must have in your college. And it is done only by team spirit, remember. It is done by only team spirit. You will find that illness, you know, in that illness, if I replace by I by we, then illness becomes wellness. So illness of NAC process, it becomes wellness of NAC process. If you replace I by we, that is team spirit, combined efforts. So remember all these things. Now I shall go step by step to all questions of criteria. Some questions are there related to courses. Now these courses should be online, offline courses by every department. Every department must have 2 courses every year. Those courses, they should be skill oriented, some of them job oriented, value added, communication skill, soft skill. Related to neighboring industry also skill potential that should be required because focus on employability you have to give. Those courses should be innovative courses. Remember, like this, some names I shall give for courses. Corporate social responsibility, critical reasoning, accent training, Japan accent, Germany accent for getting appointment there. Sustainable development, employability techniques, e-training modules, foreign trade, global finance market related, cyber crime, ethical hacking, remote sensing, network security. Such type of courses they should be there. More students they should be admitted. About 25, 40, 50% students in every year. you can take from government agency, from non-government agency also. MOOC courses are there, SWAYAM courses are there, NPTEL is giving courses, ISAR is giving courses. So you can have different types of courses from different agencies. And some courses, you have to design the syllabi and take 30-hour duration period, give the certificate of the principal, no necessity of taking permission from university or anybody. So in that manner, you have to think. Then there are some questions related to slow learners and advanced learners. In fact, you have to give the system. I shall tell that principal will give a notice in this manner. After teaching a topic in every department, you take a class test of 20 marks, below 40% slow learner, above 60% advanced learners identified in each department. And for them, you take one or two periods separately for slow learners and advanced learners in every month. For slow learners, you may be doing something, but these things are necessary. You have to take tutorials to them, bridge courses, remedial coaching, counseling programs, difficult topics repeated, more books are given to them, study material is given to them. Then I can have, in this manner, JLG seminar you must give. What is the JLG seminar? It is Joint Liability Group seminar. What is that actually? Every department must have at least one JLG seminar in every class every month. In that, slow learner will ask difficulties to advanced learner and teacher. They will solve that, take on a piece of paper and make a video clip of that joint liability group seminar. Slow learners are asking, advanced learner, teacher are solving them. Peer team member definitely will ask what efforts you are doing in bringing slow learner to the advanced learner level. So you can say that such JLG seminar. It is participative learning type. So you can have in second criteria, JLG seminar is in participative learning. I am thinking all these things in all respect to get A++ grade also if you think, if you do that 100%. Then you will find that for advanced learner, you can have whatever you are doing, you must have ICT training for them. You must give better training for better placement in national, international, on national, international level. You can give mini research project, some resources, e-learning resources they should use, some software also they should use. You can give them brainstorming sessions in the form of case study, event analysis, situation analysis, and TPS seminar again. What is this? I shall explain. Subject related, any topic you can give, subject related. For example, Article 370 removal was there in Jammu and Kashmir. You can give, political science people can give that topic. They will think over it, or you give the material. They will write on a piece of paper that higher advanced learner will share with his, will pair with his friend, and both of them, they will give seminar or webinar in the class. That is thinking, pairing, sharing. You can give some scientist work. You can give thinker work. Some scientific, some award winner. In that manner, some topic you can give in the form of case study, event analysis, situation analysis also. You can give some topics. Advanced learners will write on a piece of paper and you can have a folder in your computer having brainstorming sessions in the department. You have to transfer to IQAC. IQAC will collect all the department in that manner and he will say that there are 200 brainstorming sessions in our college during NAS 5 years period. Principal should say such type of word, impressive, quality inclined in that manner. Then, case study, some examples you have to take from student, event analysis, situation analysis in that manner. So you keep all these things in that way. You can use the word for advanced learner like HOTS. HOTS means higher order thinking skills are given to them. So you can have different new words, different innovatively you can have. You will find that in every college, all these things are done very nicely, no problem. But in cross verification, peer team member will expose all the things. What happens, you know, you are having this slow learner, advanced learner, mentor-mentee system, all the systems you are having. But some student will say that system is not there. Some parent will say that system is not there. Even I say that principal tells in his presentation, there are 100 computers in the college, some student will say 80 computers, some faculty will say some 70 computers. In that manner, they will think, and that cross verification will lower down the grade. So for this again, I am giving one system to you. Every college must prepare, after preparing your SSR, one document. That document is known as KYC. Actually, KYC is required in banks. But I say KYC means it is know your college. And in this document, write name of the principal, subject name, teacher name, total number of books, number of computers, these mentor-mentee, all these systems, everything you write, put on college notice board, put on college website, take orientation program of them before peer team comes to your college, so that everybody will say the same figure as principal told. So this KYC document is also very important you have to perform. Then I'm knowing you also know that there are two types in framework, qualitative metrics and quantitative metrics. In quantitative metrics, you are required there some figures, some percentage in that manner, that should be more in number. Do not write 2, 3, 4, it should be 25, 40, 50, 80, 90% or number also in that way. You have to write qualitative metric document also in 500, 200, 1000 words. There, that also you have to write carefully, with skill you have to write. Quality inclination, it should be reflected in that. I shall give some sentences for you. You can write somewhere, the college is marching towards excellence in all possible quality ways and latest technologies from time to time. You must say somewhere that all our faculty members are training the brains of the student for their placement gain and overall development. Tree plantation you have to write, plantation and preservation words should be written. College must be made digital every year. If somebody who does that, he should say that college is made digital because this is the place where our past meets our present for our better future. You will find that all these things, they are very necessary. Green practices you are doing. So somebody will say that we are performing green practices in the college to nurture the nature for our future. How is the sentence? To nurture the nature for our future. Why corona problem have come? Why dengue, swine flu, environmental global problems are coming? We are disturbing the nature. So we have to work according to that. Because world is going digital, herbal, spiritual. India is also going digital, herbal, spiritual. Colleges also must work for digitalness, herbalness and spiritualness in college and surrounding community also. Think over it. All these things, they come under that. There is one document, 1.1.1. You have to write curriculum delivery document. In that document, every college is writing that we are having teaching plan, academic calendar, group discussion, seminar, everything you are writing. But forget two things. Very important. First thing is, you must write there, IQAC conducts a meeting in the beginning of every academic year to verify the syllabi of each subject of the college from the affiliated university. And second line should be there, the college is having online academic monitoring system. What does this mean? That means college must have LMS, learning management system, MIS, management information system, and ERP, enterprise resource planning. Computer department of the college can do, or you can have MOU collaboration with some software agency or some computer institute. You have to take ICT training also for staff in that manner. That is useful. So that type of online academic monitoring system means, I told earlier, that on the day you perform the activity, make a folder, transfer to IQAC in that way. So all these things, that is very necessary. Then second document you have to prepare in second criteria, regarding teaching learning methods. There you are having three types, experimental, participative and problem based. In participative, you are writing group discussion, seminars, now webinars also you may be taking, online sessions, JLG I told, TPS I told, you can have. You are having in the college some guidance talk also, but I give innovation in that. You say, we have a system of MIE and MAE. MIE means meat industry expert. MAE means meat academic expert. Meeting, I am saying, if he is from industry side, he will give seminar or webinar, and thereafter you can have interactive session with the student, question answer session. That meeting part with the student and video clip of that is to be taken. That is good participative learning method. Then one more thing that should be there in every college, a one classroom with 25-50 computers in LAN. Every teacher must take at least one period every month with LCD and PPT teaching. After teaching a topic, he will give some 2-3 questions. Students will write in their respective computers, and teacher will go from computer to computer to see the answers of that question. And video clip of that is to be taken. That is known as participative e-learning method adopted in the college. That is very important. Then experimental part also is there. In that you must have some courses with experimental training. You can have mock bank, mock parliament, or some experimental. So in experimental training, you must have some artificial intelligence like software you have to use. One multi-sim software is there. Other softwares are also there. You can create virtually on the wall of the classroom. Physics people can have electric circuit on the wall of the classroom. Political science people can have Lok Sabha, Vidhan Sabha working on the wall of the classroom. In that manner, virtual learning platforms, they should be created in the college. So in experimental part, you have to download some videos also, subject-related videos. You have to show those videos to the student. You take some videos, some skill-oriented videos are also there. You show such videos to students. And evidence should be kept in that manner. Then problem-based, in that you are having class test, open book test, surprise test, pre-annual exam, all those things you are having in the college. But online tests are also to be taken. Online tests with software, quiz competitions you have to take, MCQ, multiple choice questions you have to in that manner. In quiz competition, you can have inter-group, inter-class, inter-collegiate, inter-university, inter-state level, inter-university level, whatever it may be. You can have webinars also of that type. In the college campus also, if after Corona, you can have. So such type of online, offline activities of quiz competitions, like MCQ also, multiple choice question in Kongbanyaka Korotpati, you have seen. So such type of thing you can have on different topics. You can have Corona situation in Karnataka, Corona situation in India. Mangalyaan Chandrayaan was there. So you can give the topic to all colleges and just quiz competition. What was Mangalyaan Chandrayaan? One female student and one male student will participate in that. Such type of new things, they should be there in your college, remember. Then there are some questions related to collaborations, MOU and linkages. And these collaboration MOU, they should be on local level, district level, state level, national level, international level. There is one question in IIQA, you have to submit before your report. In that, there is one question, is there any foreign collaboration of your college? Most of the colleges, they write no. Why no? You make some collaboration. I may tell you a simple example. You can have collaboration with foreign small country, maybe Nepal, Bhutan, Sri Lanka, for webinar. You take a document of that type, that educationist from that Nepal university, you take one webinar every year, your grade goes up by such step. These collaboration MOU linkages, they should be taken with subject-related organizations that you are having. National, state level, international level also, like ICHR, ICSSR, IITs, IIM, software companies are there, ISRO, NASA, National Chemical Laboratory, National Entrepreneurship Network, Institute of Chartered Accountants, Chamber of Commerce are there, National Skill Development Board, IUCA, archives are there, History Department can do. Then libraries are there, state level, national level libraries, publishing houses are there. So any subject related organization, you can have MOU collaboration. You will find that MOU means it is a document signed by your principal and that head of the institute. Collaboration, it is for 1 month, 1 day, one year, in that manner you have to write collaboration. And linkage, you have to explain there for the following linkage. And there the words are given in that framework. Like student exchange program, faculty exchange program, on-job training, internship, experiential training, all the words they are there, you take all the words there. That should be more in number. Department wise, every department must have one or two webinars every year, and on college level also, some 2-3 webinars every year. Such type of webinar, functional MOUs, they should be increased. Between 25 to 50 they should be. So all these things you keep in mind and work accordingly. Then there are some questions related to you. Teacher profile and qualities, teacher related. Working on university body, you have to write research papers published, books published, all those things you can write. Simple things I am not telling here. But remember one thing, you have to work, colleges, the faculty should work for removing the diversities in the neighboring area. In 7 criteria, it is mentioned there, you have to study the diversities, maybe economic, biodiversity, sociodiversity, linguistic, cultural, subject related, some social activity should be done by adopting some village in neighboring park. You have to make the research in this manner, which is useful for community, which is useful for some farmer or some company also. Principal should say in his presentation that there are 100 research papers published in our college, but 5 research papers are useful from paper to people and lab to land. That is important. Academic activities conducted for faculties in the college, academic activities conducted for students in the college, and participation of both of them outside the college activities, that is also important. So you think all of this in that manner and go accordingly. One international conference, one national conference, one state level conference, and others, university level, regional level workshops, seminars, they should be taken in 5 years. There are some questions of committees. Different committees are there in the colleges. I shall tell you some innovative committees. First is ESEL committee. That is the entrepreneurship step. That will work for personality enhancement program, personality development program, employment enhancement training program. You will find that some business expo, business carnivals, they should take in that manner. That is also important. You will find that this will work for self-employed also. That is also necessary. You will find that one committee, I shall tell it is STEP committee. Science and Technology Entrepreneurship Park, combined activities that can be done. One committee I shall tell it is COIL committee, COIL, that is Center of Industrial License. Industrialized all activities, they should be taken. One more committee I shall tell it is CORE committee, that is Center of Relevance and Excellence. And this CORE committee will work for efforts for placement and coaching for computer exams, taking general knowledge tests, useful for banking, SATNET, GRE, TOEFL. In fact, I may tell that 2 tests every month you have to take. One test for banking, for SATNET, GRE, in that year you complete, and other tests you give in this manner. Every day you give 10 questions and 10 answers every day on college notice board. In every month you will have 300 questions and 300 answers. Out of that, you just give 50 questions and 50 answers will be given by the student in that general knowledge test. Fix the date, 1st day and 10th day. That is very useful for getting appointments. Then the committee meetings, you have to take every semester 1 or 2 meetings. IQC must have 4 meetings minimum in the beginning, at the end of the first term, in the beginning of second term, at the end of the second term. Every committee, every department also must have a departmental meeting for planning and monitoring. So all these things you keep in mind and go accordingly with evidences in that manner. Then I am coming to next part, that is main part of ICT. What is ICT? Total ICT I am giving you in this manner. Yes. So I am coming to ICT technology now. What is ICT technology? In fact, it is given there e-governance and e-communication. In library, administration, accounts, exam, everywhere, that paperless, it should be there. You must have system, I told you earlier. E-communication should be there from principal to staff, and staff to student. 10 communications every month you must have. Teacher-wise, class-wise, you must have Google Classroom, QR code or any other email-generated system. Do not use Facebook, WhatsApp, Telegram in that manner. Email-generated system is used, and for such ICT technology activities and methods you have adopted, you form one committee also. That committee, I shall tell you, it is SMILE committee. SMILE means it is Social Media International Learning Education. Don't use WhatsApp, Facebook, I told you, email generated system. That SMILE committee will sit in a class, in a room. That room is known as media room or audiovisual room. Write down the names of the department in that room, economics, English, chemistry in that manner. Below that you must write PPTs in the department, videos, software views in that manner, and totality of that is taken by principal in his presentation. Principal should say there are 1000 videos in different departments of in 10 departments, 15 departments of the college in that manner. 1000 videos, that is not much figure I am telling you. 1000 videos in 5 years I am telling. So 200 videos per year. If 10 departments are there in the college, only 20 videos per department per year. That means only 2 videos you have to prepare per month per department. So in that manner you have to project. E-communication for that Google Classroom QR code, 10 communications by each teacher class-wise every month you have to give. QR code you have to prepare as Paytm advertisement you have seen, that quick response code by each department. At the entrance of the department you must have one wall magazine with QR code. Current event related articles, some videos you can show to them on that QR code and all those things. Yearly all departments they have collected all such wall magazines. Selected part is taken on college website and that is given the name e-magazine. When PhD members come to your college, after looking to your college website, they will think that this college is of A grade, A plus grade, A double plus grade. That's why you have to just have ICT technology, everything on college website. Then you have to use open education resources. Swayam is there, e-Pathshala, e-Adhyayan, e-School, MOOC courses are there, Moodle, Unnat Bharat Abhiyan related you have to work. Then computer systems you must have like Socrative, Edmodo, Tano, TestU, Fox Computing, FOSS, free open source software you can have. FOSS, FWS. Then Technic of Prezi, Ruby, Linux, Maya, Flash, XAMP, LAMP, Raspberry Pi, eKalpa, eYantra, Selenium, TeamViewer, DreamViewer, Libra, Flipped Classrooms, FileZilla, Presentation Tube, Blockchain technology you have to use, Solo Learning, Cancel.com, Joomla, Virtual Learning Platforms I told you, Mobile Learning Platforms, LabVIEW, NetBeans, Blended Learning, 3D Printing Technology, Slide Sharing, Virtual Learning Environment you have to create, a system of DigiLocker, Dropbox. Then some new techniques are there in computer science like IoT, Internet of Things, Artificial Intelligence, Big Data, Hadoop Software, Python Language, Android Development Tools you have to develop. Then there is a concept of cloud computing, you have to use that. There are 4 types of cloud computing. Community cloud, public cloud, private cloud and hybrid cloud. There are 4 types of software in that cloud computing. RAAS, Infrastructure as a Source. PAAS, platform as a source, HAAS, hardware as a source, SAAS, software as a source. Use one of them. That is essential. You have to create soundcloud.com in the campus. Moodle cloud sites you have to create, cloud related. Own cloud system you can have. Cloud campus audio system also you can develop. All these things are necessary. You are knowing Wi-Fi. But there is Li-Fi also, light fidelity. If 2 laptops, 2 computers are there, light is thrown on one, the information goes to other laptop by light fidelity. You are knowing computers in LAN, in that manner computers in MAN, M-A-N, Metropolitan Area Network, WAN, Wide Area Network, VPN, Virtual Private Network. It is used for distance learning classes. So you can have all this. There is a concept of e-green computing. that e-green computing is for e-waste material to reduce, to recycle and to reuse. Most of the colleges they are using. Even drone, you have to use drone also. Using drone. Using robot-related technology. For, remember that for drone, you must have some, or for robot technology, you must have some MOU also. With that MOU, you can use the robot technology or drone also. One company I am knowing, it is Four Forces Aero Product India. That is giving you drone idea, drone training. Four Forces Aero Product India. You will find that there are five types of these technologies in the world. Latest. First is IT, that you know, information technology. BT, biotechnology. NT, nanotechnology. QT, quantum technology. And one more is there. CT, cognitive technology. And this cognitive technology has five subjects which are familiar to you. Philosophy, psychology, anthropology related to history, neuroscience, and artificial intelligence. So these are new parts that are there, they are coming. That should be reflected in your report. Do not go as before. You will get C grade, B grade, even rejected also. And money will not come if you don't have 2.50 above grade. So all these things that I am telling you, there are different types of software. Some common software you are having like MS Office, PageMaker, Front Page, Acrobat Reader, CorelDRAWware, G-Lite. Every department can use. Some software for commerce, economics you can have like Taxable, TaxBase, ERP9, RDMS. You can have such software. Some software for languages also I may tell like Sri Lipi, OmniLite, Hello English, Tanaka, Rocket Hindi, Grammarly website, language converter in that manner. For science subject also, some software you can have like Science Lab, FactXZ, GeoGebra, LaTeX, Mathematica, RStudio, ResMoss, MathCAD, Microsoft Equation, ChemDraw, PyMOL, BKChem, Mercury, XRD, Rigaku, UV Visible, DigiFrog for science subject. So you can have such innovation. Every department some have something. And principal should say all of them in consultation. In library also I may tell you that library is a place to explore within you and unknown to you. So you must have all these things. Library advisory committee, that should be in existence effectively. Full automation in the library. Separate website of the college. E-resource corner, e-competition corner, and reading room separately you must have. Daily user should be more. Then Dellnet, Infibnet, eShowSindhu, eShowGanga, WebOPEC, Digital Media Library, Online Database System. Some of these you must have. National Digital Library Access, Easy Life, library related Android mobile applications, e-audiobooks, e-videobooks, talking books, QR code system, e-magazine concept that I told you earlier. Then one activity, e-brain activity, that brain means book reading and information network. What is that activity? That librarian should give general book, scientist book, autobiography, something to students. They will write on a piece of paper content of the book and librarian will have a folder of that type, e-brain activity, book reading and information network. This wall magazine, at the entrance of the library, you must have the job opportunities of that month or of that week in that manner. Online, offline, daily record you must have. Radio frequency identification device, RFID, or some online system, footfall, scanners, you must have. Kibo, Kindle, Koha, Kiosk, you can use any. Libman, Braille Lipi related software also you must have. Even though blind persons are not there, blind students are not there, inclusion and situatedness, it comes under that. Even though it is not there, if such student comes, still we have obtained one or two Braille Lipi software. All these things are important, remember. User orientation program librarian should give. Some skill oriented videos librarian should give. ICT applied messages they must have all the time. Paperless working. So library should have in this way. You will find that there are questions related to ratios now. Three types of ratios are there: student-computer ratio, student-teacher ratio, and mentor-mentee ratio. When I say student-computer ratio, that should be 1:1. Student-teacher ratio, most of the college principals, they call me, sir, I cannot do NAC because I don't have faculty member. But I am giving you one tip here, that in last 5 years, I have given A grade to 25 colleges in Kerala, in so many states, Gujarat, West Bengal, so many states I have given. They received A grade. They were having only 3 faculty members regularly appointed. One was principal, second was NAC coordinator, and third one was librarian. Others were contractual basis, clock hour basis, in that manner they were working. Still I have given A grade with all these things. Remember, my general practice is, this type of guidance talk I shall give first, maybe going to college or through webinar. Then I take departmental interaction. And in that departmental interaction, I listen to every department what they have done and give innovative techniques department wise. For 10 to 15 minutes every department I shall give, such 3 hours talk next. Then thereafter, criteria person's difficulties, their answer that is written, those are checked by me, then report is checked by me. Then after sending the report, I give PPTs, required PPTs for principal, everybody, likely questions, and lastly mock visit. In that manner, even though I have visited, I have given guidance talks to 900 above colleges, out of that some 470 colleges they received up till now A+, A++ day. Some colleges, some I think 70 colleges they are going to submit before December. I am going to such colleges now. Recently I was there in Rajasthan, in Himachal Pradesh. Now I am going to West Bengal, in Gujarat also. Next I am going to Punjab. So in that manner that goes on. So with this particular thing, you can have higher grade, you can have a lot of money in education policy that is coming. Then mentor-mentee system also, it is there. In mentor-mentee system, principal again will give you a notice of this type. That mentor-mentee system in this particular year, it will run as follows. In July, you will have August you can take. In August, career counseling. In September, competitive exam guidance. In October, something else given in the report. In that manner, you put that. Keep the evidences. Some infrastructural questions are also there. I may say one thing only, that depending upon the strength of the student every year in the college, every academic, IT, support facility, NSS, NCC, all those, they should be made available, sufficient, and utility should be made. Utility is very important. Daily users in the library, you write 2%, 3%. No, it should be more percentage, more number daily users you have to mention everywhere. There is one question there in infrastructural part. How many classrooms are there in the college? For example, you write suppose 100 classroom. Thereafter one question is there. How many are ICT enabled classroom? And there you write only 4. That means what percentage you get? 4%. In fact, it should be more than 50%. More than 50%, 75, 80, 90, 100% classroom, they should be ICT enabled. Some of them, they are having Wi-Fi. Some of them LCD, some smart board, interactive board, or the other ICT facility. You have to do the maintenance policy also of the infrastructure. You have to upgrade the infrastructure every year. You have to write nature of the upgradation with date. That is very important. All these things, they are very important. Then there are some questions regarding internal evaluation, like program outcome, course outcome, continuous internal evaluation, reforms, evaluation of learning outcomes. In that manner, the understanding is, whatever you teach, what is the evaluation methods of the college? University result is there, from parent feedback you can have, and through regular tests like class test, surprise test, open book test, online test, through question answer session you can test them, give mini project to them, minor project you can have, some surveys through that you can have, higher order thinking skills I told you, exhibition, college competition, quiz competition, through that also you can test. You can have on departmental level some tests, on college level pre-annual tests. So in that manner, different methods are taken by different departments in your college. Every year you have to change. This department is performing 3-4 methods this year. that will be shifted to other department. In that manner, whatever you are doing, all these things you have to explain, principal has to explain in that manner. Then there are some questions related to cross-cutting issues. Again, for this answer, report is rejected nowadays. Summary is given there. Correct way of writing is cross-cutting issues, which are they? Gender related, environment related, human values related, ethics related. So you have to write in this manner, how many subjects are there in your college? In botany, you are teaching suppose environment chapter. In sociology, you are teaching suppose gender related chapter. In that manner, you have to do subject-wise that thing. Thereafter, some courses if you are taking, you write down the details of that. Thereafter, some programs if you are taking, you have to take programs also of that type, related to that part. Do not repeat any activity anywhere in any criteria. Once only. Do not repeat the student also. Maximum number of students should be involved in different committees, different committees and different activities, sports, cultural, academic, whatever it may be, courses also. Because one SSR was rejected, principal was telling me that the college was having 1,000 students. In the report, they have given only 200 students. Query came from DVV, Data Validation Verification Center. College replied that the remaining student didn't turn up to the college. Immediately, the report was rejected. Even though it is not, they are not turning, you have to take some online activity with them. You have to involve all the students. So remember all these things in this way. Then I am coming to the main part of IQAC. Now IQAC is for planning, monitoring and record keeping of all academic activities in the college. IQAC is responsible for stakeholders meeting. Student, teacher, alumni, parent, employer, everybody. Academic audit, administrative audit, quality audit they have to take. Incremental improvement they have to give. Achievements and awards, for that also they have to take efforts. After my talk, most of the colleges, they are going to nearby villages, nearby junior colleges and nearby villages where top players are there. Some top academicians, top students are there, academic students. And the students are admitted to the college with free admission and that student will give achievement award as required by NAC on state level, national level, university level. So you have to take efforts for achievements and awards also. Achievements and awards cannot be brought or cannot be bought also by giving money, remember. So for prominent alumni and placement, they have to work. As far as alumni is required, you must have functional, registered alumni contributing to the development of the college in financial and non-financial ways. When I say registered with the government, state government, financial contribution, 1 lakh rupees, in 5 years, you must have. In non-financial contribution, some books are given, guidance stock is given, some experiential training is given in alumni company. In that manner, you have to create the record. Functional means you must take 2 meetings every year in that way. So in that way, you must have everything. IQC must take care of that. AQR, regularly AQR you have to send, 5 AQRs. That is also very essential. Parent teacher association, that should be effective. Everything is given there. You must be implementing all the things. And one important thing I am telling you now. Some MOU should be done with IQAC. Functional MOU. For quality initiatives and quality audit. I am solving this problem also. One company have appointed me as competent authority. You can have registration with that company, everything I shall do. I am appointed competent authority, so I shall sign each and every document of the college, from MOU, everything. Just you have to register with them. That company name is Seshadri Globally Technological. Seshadri Globally Educational Technological Agency. Remember, their email ID is ambaisheshadri@gmail.com. ambaisheshadri@gmail.com. You send the mail to them, director SGECT in that way. that we want to have MOU for our college IQC quality audit pro forma. I am having, I shall send that. Some innovative courses syllabi I am having, I shall send that. Even I can say that if PLT members are coming in the college in the month of January, you can take one activity in earlier month, December. You take my online signature on each and every document. And you can tell to the PLT members that recently, last month only, we have taken by this MOU, this activity. In this way, it is so functional. So that will give you good higher grade in that manner. You send the mail to them and you can convey me on my WhatsApp also. My WhatsApp number, I am telling you, it is 72 76 37 58 20. Once again, I tell you, 72 76 37 58 20 20. Another number is there, 1010 calling number. So you can have in that manner and do accordingly. Last part I am taking now, it is of extension social activities and criteria 7. Extension social activities you have to give in criteria 3 by NSS, NCC, sports, cultural department. There only you write down in the answer NSS. Everywhere do not write that. NSS, NSS. And in 7 criteria, it is subject related social activity. There some words are there. Locational advantage, locational disadvantage, inclusion and situatedness, tolerance and harmony towards diversity, economic, bio, I told you earlier. So adapt some village. Make some scarcity of water, scarcity of something is there in neighboring area. Water problem, other energy, alternative energy problem, solar energy like that also you give awareness. Everything you can have with neighboring community. You call the villagers in your college every year, some 50 or 100 villagers, community people. Every teacher can give half an hour talk to them. Botany people can give idea of organic farming. Political science people will give voter awareness program, Right to Information Act. Commerce people can give minimum cost, maximum crop, how it is obtained. Economics people can give internet banking idea. All such details I give in next my departmental interaction webinar. And that will be very useful. This is the general canvas picture I am giving to you of NAC. You have to fill with quality colors in that manner. So remember, this extension activities in 7.1, you are having different energy audit, green audit, then physically handicapped facilities, all these things you do there. That is the college's brand establishment. Then 7.2, you have to give two best practices. You must have, for two best practices, you must have student involvement, community involvement and technology use. I shall give you two best practices. I am having around about 50 best practices I am having, I can give for somebody. I shall give two best practices you can have in this manner. One is digital economic literacy in your region, and second one is industrial revolution and job placement in your region. 2.5 year one practice, 2.5 year other practice, by calling sections of the societies, maybe women, senior citizen, school going children, handicap, in that manner you can think. And in 7.3, you have to give institutional distinctiveness. And for this answer again, reports are rejected nowadays. Summary of the report is written here. One principal was here and he has given his SSR. I just saw that report. In last question, he has given only summary. I told it is very wrong. It will be rejected. Correct way of writing is, you have to write one point of your vision mission in inverted commas in the beginning. And you have to write below that, the following is the explanation of performance of our college with vision mission points stated above, having thrust and priority. That is your distinctiveness in that manner. And you have to write below that. So it is for female child, your college, it is for downtrodden class. So in that manner, stick up to that point only, and that particular event you do not write anywhere. So in that way, that 7.3 you have to write carefully. I may tell you that in fact you have to identify local needs and seeds of the potential in your neighboring area for the development of the student, development of the college and developing community also, neighboring community. You will find that this education policy is coming. You have to face the change all the time. Do not change the face. Changing the face will create problem. Facing the change will have career advancement. Change is there everywhere. This Lord Krishna, you may be knowing, in Mahabharata, Lord Krishna has told that change is the law of universe. Everywhere change will be there. You have to accept it. Learning to learn concept is important nowadays. Learned people are important, but learning people, they are more important. Living to learn and learning to live, that concept is very important. You may be knowing Goddess Saraswati, Vidya Devata. In that Vidya Devata Saraswati, you are having one book in her hand. I am thinking that one book is there, still she is the goddess of Vidya, wisdom. I think that she is still learning something from the present situation. So everybody must have that idea. I see internet every day. What is global education coming? What is Indian education system coming? Every day I just see internet every day, half an hour before my sleep. That habit you must have. So this learning to learn concept is also important. This educational sector is becoming now economic sector. You may be knowing that. It has impact beyond the college boundaries. So you have to think out of the box and out of the syllabi for the development. Do not tell your excuses. Do not tell weaknesses. In fact, weaken your weaknesses and strengthen your strength. Global vision with social responsibility and educational awareness, that is very important. I may tell you that every person has 120 dimensions in their brain. We all are using 30 to 40 dimensions. Even Lata Mangeshkar or Sachin Tendulkar are also using same in playing and singing. But we teachers, we have to work with compulsions and compromises. We have to use more dimensions all the time of the brain. Up till now, whatever you have done, forget about that. Hereafter, every faculty member will give one idea to their principal. With these ideas, principal's ideas, one college brand will be established. NAC grade will be the byproduct of that. Everybody must have proactive mindset with two mobiles, not pocket mobile. Mind mobile and brain mobile. They should be charged with willpower charger. I am telling you all faculty members, do not do this snack because principal is telling, because government made compulsory. You do for yourself. Your proactiveness will take you to career advancement. Lastly, I shall tell one story and one Sherochari share and I shall stop. That story is again NAC related. In the forest, three brothers having 17 peacocks, they were quarreling. Elder brother wanted 50%, second brother third part, third brother wanted ninth part. Cannot be done. In that forest, one proactive mindset person, NAC was not there, but he wanted to do some community work. He was having one peacock. He came to three brothers and told, I shall distribute. He added his one peacock to 17, 18 peacocks. Elder wanted 50%, 18 by 2, 9 peacocks, 18 by 3, 6 peacocks, 18 by 9, 2 peacocks, 9 plus 6 plus 2, 17 peacocks of brothers given to them as per their desire. His 18th peacock he has taken out. Your college madam also yesterday asked me to bring my peacock today. I brought it. I am not here to distribute anything among you. I am here to tell you that use your potential in the manner now or never. If you get good grade, you will be in the heaven in that way. Quality heaven. Lot of money will be there for individual departments and for college also. Lastly, I shall tell only one Sherochari share and I shall stop. NAC ke liye achha grade mile na mile, ye to mukaddar ki aur aapke efforts ki baat hai, magar uske liye जी जान से कोशिश न करना ये गलत बात है. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
थैंक यू वेरी मच सर. ओइंग टू टाइम कंस्ट्रेंट्स वी आर एक्सट्रीमली सॉरी दैट वी कैन नॉट टेक अप मेनी क्वेश्चंस, बट इफ एनी पार्टिसिपेंट हैज ए क्वेश्चन मे बी वी कैन look into one or two questions. Any participant wants to ask any question? Some participants have posted some requests in the chat box. I assure you that we will look into your requests later. Any participant wants to ask any question? You can switch on your audio and ask the question.
Hello, sir.
Bolo.
Professor Ramla.
Hello.
उनसे बात कर रही हो
सर,
आईक्यूएसई के लिए कोई रिपोर्ट है क्या सर?
फॉर्मेट
आईक्यूएसई के लिए क्वालिटी इनिशिएटिव एंड इंक्रीमेंटल इम्प्रूवमेंट फॉर एवरी ईयर यू हैव टू जस्ट मेक ए डॉक्यूमेंट ऑफ दैट टाइप.
ओके, पर्टिकुलर फॉर्मेट कुछ भी नहीं है ना उसके लिए?
फॉर्मेट नहीं. आप कौन से कॉलेज से है?
ऋषा विद्या कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड मैनेजमेंट कटपाड़ी उडुपी.
उडुपी, व्हाट इज योर नेम?
रमलत.
अच्छा, यू जस्ट कॉल मी आफ्टरवर्ड, इन डिटेल आई शैल टेल समथिंग रिगार्डिंग दैट.
थैंक यू. विल यू प्लीज हाईलाइट ऑन ग्रीन ऑडिट सर? ग्रीन ऑडिट?
नो, एक्चुअली व्हाट इज देयर, यू नो, ग्रीन ऑडिट हैज डिफरेंट क्वेश्चंस देयर इन दैट ग्रीन ऑडिट. There are some agencies doing that, green audit, environment audit. So you have to just approach them and make that green audit, environment audit. Like that, energy audit is also done by some agencies. So with that agency, you just approach and make that energy audit report also. It should have registered energy audit agency. For this green audit also, registered agency should be there. And as I told you, for quality audit, I am associated with registered agency. So that is influential in that way.
Yes, sir. But being a undergraduate college, definitely we will have the budget constraint. But when we approach...
What I told, do not tell excuses, do not tell weaknesses.
No, sir.
I'm telling you. Madam, this is going on since last 1947 from independence. Today is Independence Day, isn't it? Today is Independence Day. It is going from 1947 to up till now. When are you going to change that? You have to change. You have to accept the change. You should be global. Do not say only I am global. You should act like global.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it?
Yes, sir. We are ready to accept the changes. But still, sir, when the students' strength is coming down and when the colleges are facing a budget constraint, very difficult to go for all these MOUs with or MOU with other agencies and all, and to pay audit, green audit and other audits and all. They charge too much. This is what we are trying for the past several years. So
you are from which college you are there?
St. Agnes College, Autonomous, sir. I'm the librarian of the college, Dr. Vishala, from St. Agnes College, Autonomous.
Okay. Yes, I'm telling you, all these participants, if they have questions, they may ask me after this webinar. I am free on my phone call. I can repeat my phone number. It is 72-76-37-58-20.
Noted down, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Okay, we come to the end of this webinar. As we close this webinar, I request Shri Pashma Tajri, Associate Professor in the Department of Commerce of our college, to propose the vote of thanks.
Good afternoon. As we have come to the end of this webinar, I deem it my privilege to propose the vote of thanks. Firstly, I thank Sri M. Abhijit, the Secretary of our Management, Digambar Jain Vidyavardhak Sangh Moodibidri, for his inaugural address and for his inauguration of this seminar. Thank you, sir. Our special thanks are due to Dr. Dharmadikari N.S. from Pune, the UGC committee member, for his great voices of spirit and concern on natural quality enhancement initiatives. Thank you very much, sir. I also thank the principal of our college, Dr. Sudarshan Kumar, IQAC coordinator, Dr. Padmaja Shetty. Lastly, I thank all my colleagues and participants of this webinar for making this webinar a grand success. Thank you, one and all.
With this, we come to the close of this webinar. I request all the participants to submit the feedback form. The feedback link is posted in the chat box. It will also be sent to the webinar WhatsApp group. So kindly submit your form and you will receive your certificate in a couple of days. Once again, I thank all the participants.